All right, so moving on to our next story, which we have a few more left. Man, this is an action-packed, a lot of stories in this episode. We're talking about some Digimon delays, both in the US and in Japan. So looking at the anime, the new Digimon Adventure reboot, that is being delayed. This was actually talked about in April, but still want to mention it right now since I'm going to be mentioning some US news in a little bit. But the anime literally was delayed after its fourth episode, or sorry, after its third episode. It was supposed to air its fourth on April 26th, but of course, things got very, very, very delayed because it still has not come back now. There's no talk about when it will be coming back. And I want to mention that, you know, I mentioned this before in the episode, but I want to say it again for anyone saying, but why would they air only a few more episodes? Well, they probably, due to certain contracts and things like that, and even though it's Toei, so their animation stuff is in-house, I would imagine, for the most part, but when it comes to television contracts and whatnot, they probably had to wait till it got to the level where they could legally say, hey, this is an act of God, so we gotta do something about this. And I'm assuming that's what ended up happening. I don't believe they announced the state of emergency at this point in Japan. I believe that was announced in May. But either way, though, at a certain point, sadly, you are beholden to all of these contracts, and it's only until it gets that bad that some companies and corporations have to then pull out. So I'm assuming that's why they ended up airing three episodes, because I think even before the first episode aired, I was sitting around going, this will be delayed. Like I was not looking forward to it. Ended up being delayed, so I didn't really check it out, even though it was available on Crunchyroll. So it's nice that Toei was putting it out through a source while it was airing in the US, but sadly, again, it got delayed, and my take on it is it probably won't be coming back till sometime early 2021. I've been saying spring over and over again, but that's still my general take on it, that this show will probably be coming back in spring of 2021. Really depends on how fast a vaccine is created and, of course, where it's created. I've been talking about, from a U.S.-centric perspective, about there being potentially a vaccine in the U.S. We don't know how things are going to work abroad. So for all we know, maybe there ends up being a vaccine in Japan and they can continue work on this in Japan. So we don't know how that's going to go. All we know is that at this time, the Digimon Adventure reboot anime is delayed. But looking at the movie, specifically Digimon Adventure Last Evolution Kizuna, that was actually supposed to come out July 7th. And Shout Factory was actually going to release it on April 20th. But they were also going to have it come out in theaters as well in the US. This was actually going to come out March 25th, but of course that got postponed in the US for obvious reasons. And it sucks because Tristan was actually going to go with a friend of his on his birthday to go see the movie. So sadly, and I was probably going to try to see if I can go see it with Satish since he's a huge Digimon fan, but sadly this ended up happening. So that was delayed in theaters. Then it seems like it was delayed even on DVD, Blu-ray on their Shout Factory's combo pack, because yeah, I mean, you can't really be selling stuff right now. I'm assuming they don't have the ability to end up putting stuff in their factories and end up having to ship those out and meet those commitments and whatnot. So of course they say it's due to a production delay, because yeah, that makes sense for a show like Digimon on such a huge scale. If this was a streaming thing, I would imagine it probably would not have been delayed, but again, it being delayed from its Fathom event screening and also from its DVD Blu-ray combo pack, it's sad. But again, I'm assuming that this one is not an April or a spring 2021 situation. This one might actually happen sometime during the fall or during the winter, just because they already have the audio done. It's literally just about shipping out the discs and meeting those commitments. But also, depending on where they're buying their discs from, they actually might be outsourcing this to another country, and that might be where the delay is that literally you can't have a boat come in with all of your DVDs if the boat isn't just there at all, if they can't even print them in their factories abroad. So I do wonder if in this case, everything is actually done on the US side of things. They just have to click the button to order and to have those come in, and then have to deal with maybe sending them out in smaller doses, but they can't even get that far if they can't get their shipment in. So I'm very curious about that, because it actually is not that difficult. If you had a product to put on a DVD, you could buy, you know, hundreds of them. Now physical media is extremely cheap. You could buy hundreds of DVDs and Blu-rays literally for under $1 a piece, depending on how many you buy. So with the DVD buying and the Blu-ray buying, that isn't the expensive part of it, or the snafu here. It's probably, in my opinion, just trying to get those to the US. So again, we'll see how that, you know, how that changes as time goes on. There's no official release date as of this time, but I'm actually assuming, I'm going to be a bit more, a bit less hesitant when it comes to this one. I'm thinking this one might actually come out in the fall or in the winter of 2020, only because all the work is done. There does not need to be any voiceovers, redoing anything like that. DVD authoring is something that could happen from someone's home workstation. So if any of that needs to be done, perhaps it's already been done, because again, it's supposed to come out on April 20th. So literally, it might just be we either don't have the staff on hand to ship all of these out, or because they can't get them all together because they'd have to be working, you know, in a factory or in the offices, or the fact that they just can't get the discs and the inserts and the boxes in time. So we'll see how this develops. Tell me what you think, though, about both this film, if you were interested in seeing it. I know I saw the trailers and I was crying. Oh god, they were beautiful. But I still haven't seen Try, so I want to see that. And I haven't seen Digimon, the earlier Digimon, the first, and Digimon 02 in a while, so I want to jump back into those. But I haven't really been keeping up with Digimon, but I saw that trailer and I was like, it's okay, guys. You're gonna make it through it, okay? So either way, though, tell me what you think about the film, if you want to see it, and also about the new anime. Again, didn't check that one out because I knew it was gonna be delayed. But tell me what you think about that new anime. Was it living up to your expectations? All of that stuff down in the comment section down below.